Gator is really excited about our new intern.
I mean, there's a buzz going up and down the hallways about this guy. People are stopping by from other radio stations to meet our new intern.
Well, explain to me what you did before I bring him in. You said that you have been taking him around. I haven't been here Monday and Tuesday, but you've been taking him around and having him intern in other departments.
I want him to get a feel for the whole thing of radio, not just broadcasting, but our like production guy, Miles, who does commercials. I would put him in. I'd put a chair right next to Miles' computer while he's working. Put it up, let our intern sit next to him, and then I'd leave the room, and I'd come back in a few hours, and he'd still be in there. So just get a feel of production. Then I brought him over to our sales department, pulled up a chair next to our sales guy, Curtis, and I said, hey, we let him make a sales call. Do you make a cold call? You know, let him make it for you. Take him on a call. I go, I'll come back in 2 hours. Well, Curtis came back in 5 minutes and dropped us back off, so it didn't work out. I asked Bo, I go, Bo, can you show him the management side? And Bo said he was too busy that day.
He sat in with Corey for 2 hours. I think twice he got dropped off
our
with Corey.
Board op?
Yes, he sat in with him. We're not a board op for an hour. Corey brought him back after about, you know, a while. And then we brought him back over to Corey because I think he got lost or something. So.
And when Charlie was running Best Of the other day, he was sitting right next to Charlie over there. Remember you're sitting, Rover?
Yeah.
But the chair was right next to him. So I took a few pictures. So I think you guys would believe me. They were that close.
You can't it's fit, a large like, room.
You can't fit. Yeah, you can't fit two chairs over there. Am I right?
No, you can barely. I was stuck in there. I couldn't actually get out.
So basically, describing it for people who may be used to like an office setup, if you have a desk, there's two. There's two people like sitting where you normally would have one person sitting at a desk.
Like two people in one cubicle.
Well, he's got to see what's going on over there. There's a lot of stuff to learn. There's a big board. There's all kinds of monitors to look at.
But it's hard. When Charlie's got to reach around him to touch the buttons and stuff, I thought it was great. But he's learned a lot his first day, and he's back again today.
All right. Jeffrey, I believe, is his name.
Oh, crap.
I really have not met this guy.
He tries talking to Rover. Rover's like, I have to go to the bathroom.
let's bring him in. He even has his own theme music already. Here is...
Wow, look at this guy.
Jeffrey,
welcome to the show.
Are you
going to
be here while he sits down?
Yeah, grab a chair. Might as well. Why not? You want to sit over by Rover, or are you okay over there?
I'm fine over here.
Good morning, Jeffrey. How are you?
I'm doing fine.
So you just started interning this week on Rover's Morning Glory.
I've never seen Dieter help someone so much.
Oh, like, no. Dieter's
every syllable on that mic.
Dieter jumped up, adjusted the mic.
I'm afraid to miss this.
Well, I guess, this is something I've been wanting to do since high school. I mean, my first seat was really Planet when I was in first grade. I went to one of those Catholic schools that had one of those little two-way PA systems.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You know what I'm talking about? Where?
Sure.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
the PA system where you can talk to it, and it talks back.
Yeah, it's like a can on a string.
Yeah, basically. And then, and then the second seat, I was in junior high school. I was on our PA club there.
Wait a second. So the PA system...
PA public address system.
Right. Yeah, I got it. and so your school administrators would talk over the PA, and you said, I have to get into broadcasting because of this.
Something like that, because what they would do is they let me come up to the office and say hi to my teacher through the PA system. And this was, I attended St. Vincent de Paul Catholic School at the time, which is on the west side of Cleveland.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And
the second seed was what? You were in a PA club?
Yeah, I was I attended Newton D. Baker Junior High School.
Nice plug.
and nice plug for Cleveland Public Schools, I tell you.
Yeah. Oh, yes. You are a product of that, obviously.
Unfortunately. But uh-huh. I live in Lakewood now, and my kids attend Lakewood schools.
Yeah, Jeffrey may sound young to people, but how old are you really, Jeffrey?
39.
So people know.
39 years old. You are probably the oldest intern I've ever had. 39.
Hey, like I said, life threw me a couple curveballs. The best curveball that was ever thrown at me was me getting married.
So you're married?
I'm married with two kids.
How long have you been married?
I've been married 10 years.
10 years. How'd you meet this wife?
Oh, actually, my mother-in-law tells the story better than I do, but what happened was I didn't talk. When I was a little kid, I was speech-delayed when I was a kid.
I don't believe that.
No way.
You were quiet as a kid?
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, I took speech therapy when I was about when I was about 2.5 going on 3. So now my mom regrets it.
Now, yeah, he has a lot of catching up to do. Which
right?
Yeah.
How about your wife?
Oh, she what? Okay,
she's deaf actually.
No.
What?
My wife's a motor mouth sometimes.
Oh, really? So you've been married for 10 years. And how did you meet? Now, how did you meet her?
Well, she kept eyeing me. Here's the thing. She, in 1995, she moved into an apartment building that's just up the street from where my parents lived, okay? And she would walk down one side of the street to try to get my attention with one outfit, walk back, okay?
Wow.
I'm not joking. And she walked down the other side to try to get my attention, and all of a sudden, her mother was just getting exasperated about it. So one day, I was riding my bike up on my way to the bank to make a car payment.
So you're about 29 at this point.
And yeah.
You're riding your bike to the bank. Okay.
Yeah. And her mother just blurted out and said, "Hey, you, stop that bike. I want you to meet my daughter." Just like that.
And how? And tell them, how does she know that she liked you? How does she know?
Let's just say her three particular body parts leaked. That's called.
Okay. Can't say that on the radio, well, sweetie.
How can you say that, Robert?
About that.
Well, you, I can't.
Why can't you say
Dieter,
that?
Dieter, you've been in radio how long?
I know, but the way he said it, I thought it would be okay.
Well, clean up for him, Dieter.
He said that
she was aroused.
She was excited.
She was excited.
Yes, she was excited.
She was excited, and we had the chemistry, and we just clicked. You know, we dated for about a year, and then eventually we got married, and we sandwiched our wedding between Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Oh, that was smart.
You know, so
she lactated. That's basically what he was saying. Like I can say, when she first met you, she lactated. She was so excited by you.
She was excited because she had her eyes on me for so long, and I didn't realize it.
Wait, that's rare.
Wait a second. You said that there were, without saying what he said, there were three particular body parts that he didn't mention them by name. But
so we're saying the upper part, the bottom part, and then the back part.
Oh, that's four. Wait. The upper part is
the
lactation?
Part, no. It's just the front part and the top part.
Okay, so
two body parts?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So
it lactated.
Yeah, sure.
And you saw it through the shirt.
No, you I like this girl. She just revealed it to me a little later on after we started really dating and getting serious.
And how do you reveal something like that? She goes, you know, listen, Jeffrey, when I first met you, I was so aroused, my breasts started lactating.
Open your mouth.
No, I was like that. I just hope not just like my jaw dropped at that one. Uh-huh. You know, because the first day that we were actually spent time together, she just flat out said, "I want to marry you, want to have kids." I was like, what?
Wow.
But it was a good thing. I've been married. We've been through a lot. You know, the kid, you know, it's like I said, we've been married for 10 years. I love it. You know,
that's
I love
great.
Being married. And we take it one day at
that's
a time.
That's what you have to do.
Had you ever been with a girl prior to your wife?
Hell yes. Right?
Yeah, I've been with a couple of girls prior to my wife, you know, but this one was, I knew this, I just had a feeling this one was the one because my father knew one of her cousins.
Mm-hmm. It's a pretty small world.
Yeah, my dad was in the car business.
Oh. Mm-hmm. So because he was in the car business, you knew that this was the one?
No, what I'm saying is my dad knew one of my wife's cousins.
Oh, okay. Was she your first female?
First one
So this wife of yours was the first one that you had, as you put it, done that to.
That's pretty much it.
And what was, I mean, were you just like, holy, so this was about, you were 29 at the time?
Uh-huh. And then, unfortunately, and then after that, we got married.
Wait, unfortunately what?
Well.
Do you need some water? You keep licking your lips.
My mouth's dry.
Okay, let me go
get him some water.
You can't. He's looking at my water.
It's hard for me to even understand this guy talking about because dude, he's laughing so much.
Yeah. What about Jeffrey? You brought some other girl in the past. Was there a black girl?
Nothing really came of it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Nothing really came of it.
It was a good time though.
So you were 29 and you had sex with your wife for the first time when you were 29.
Mm-hmm.
And it was quite an experience. So
it was a jaw dropping experience.
Jaw dropping. Oh yeah.
I'd say it that way.
And everything's been good over the past 10 mm-hmm. years now.
We've had our ups and downs. No one ever said there's two things you have to remember when it comes to marriage and kids. They don't come with instructions.
That's a good. Is that like your motto in life?
That's always been my motto. That's how I survive marriage.
All right. So you know, some people are saying that I have some instant messages. I have some people calling into the show here. They want to know how you're 39 years old and an intern. Let him get a drink of water here. There you go. Now, you have to be in school in order to
intern. I'm currently attending the Ohio Center for Broadcasting, which is down the street from here.
Oh, wow. Oh,
I see.
Was it hard getting in there?
No.
No.
They just
take anybody.
So you contacted them and you said, I want to get into broadcasting.
I called them up, asked them, you know, the financial aid, and my wife was very supportive of it.
That's good. That's good.
It's a good plug for them.
Yes. Yes.
And I'm quite sure the school's director is a gentleman named Bruce Ryan. I'm quite sure he's listening right now.
Oh, I'm sure he's proud. I can vouch for the guy.
I can't sit here any longer.
But I learned.
I gotta go.
We're getting at in the curriculum now is we're doing how we do commercials.
Can you provide what has been instructed to you thus far?
So far we've been talking about how to use the microphone, how to position the microphone, and everything.
All right, put it towards your mouth.
Well, you know.
Have you practiced giving any commercial reads yet? For instance,
I have a mini disc on some of my commercial reads.
Let me hear you. Let's just pretend that you're doing a 60-second commercial. You know, Monster Jam is coming into town. Do I have the info for Monster Jam?
Might have just thrown it away.
Give me the Monster Jam information. Yeah, I'd like to see what you can do. Here you go. Just give them. Yeah, there you go. Now, sort of, you know, you can reword or paraphrase what this information about Monster Jam. But you know, this is a monster truck show. That's
okay. Hey, all you monster truck fans out there! The date is Saturday, February 13th, Quicken Loans Arena. Monster Jam is Saturday the 13th, two shows. Sunday the 14th, one show. Tickets on sale at www.quickenqarena.com or by calling 1-888-894-9424 or visiting any Northern Ohio Discount Drug Mart.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was a whole 60. Did it in 15.
Yeah, I know. You get your money's worth. Now you got 45 seconds to just deal.
One of the other things that we were taught how is how to actually write commercials.
Sure, of course. Wow. Right.
Yeah,
yes.
That was the other thing that we had. You know, I mean, getting in this industry because you know everyone knows that every radio station's bread and butter is commercials.
Oh yeah.
Because I know I've heard, I won't mention other stations, but I've heard them run commercial-free programming and said, well, they must not be making money.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. How are you going to make money without commercials? So, I'm really curious about finding out more about you. Now, you know, I met you briefly the other day, but we have not had any discussion or anything.
Uh-huh.
You're almost wearing what appears to be a flight suit, it looks like.
It's like a nylon jogging suit, but everyone has the assimilation it's a flight suit, but it's really not.
Because it has like a badge or like a flight, I don't know, what would you even describe it as?
Like an insignia.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so it's not a flight suit.
No, it's not a flight suit. Most flight suits are one piece.
But this is a two-piece flight suit, pretty much.
Uh-huh. So most flight suits are
one piece,
mm-hmm.
and they're green, and they just zip all the way up, and then you have to wear the harness for the parachute and the G suit and all that. It's like 40 pounds of gear to fly. It's got to wear because when you're in an F-15 or F-16, and you're out there and you're doing these really tight turns, you're being sucked into the seat. Mm-hmm. It's the G force. It's like plane. You roll the plane over, you pull back on the control stick, plane's doing this, it's like you're being sucked into the seat.
Sure. If I get you that 40-pound pack in a jumpsuit, would you wear that to work?
I don't know if I could fit in my car with it on.
I mean, put it in your trunk, when you come up here, would you wear it?
Yeah, I'd probably wear it.
So you're not, okay, cool.
You're not here.
I've been an aviation buff since I was a kid. My dad took me to my first air show when I was about 5 or 6 years old, and I was at the air show right before the Thunderbirds had their accident, where they now fly out of Hopkins.
Did you see that, or...
No, I heard about it on the news.
Okay.
They were getting ready to depart to the next air show, I think, when it happened.
Let me go. I have to take some phone calls here. Nick in Columbus, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Good morning, Nick.
Yes, you're driving a car now, is that correct?
No, I'm not.
Well, you said you couldn't fit in your car with your flight suit.
No, I said I have a small car. And I said if I tried to wear all the pilot's flight gear, I wouldn't fit in my car.
I was just curious if you finally got your car out of layaway. That's one thing I could figure. You said you'd ride your bike to the bank.
Well, no, no. Well, you're getting all that. You're getting everything all jumbled up. What I'm trying to say is, I'm trying to tell you when I was explaining to Rover how I met my wife, I was riding my bike to the bank. I didn't have a car yet.
I thought you were riding the bank to make a car payment, you said.
I was riding my bike to the bank to make a car payment. Right. So I wasn't driving my car. I felt like riding my bike. And my mother-in-law goes, my wife's mother goes, hey, you, stop that bike. I want you to meet my daughter. Just like that.
And so, but now you said that if you wear this this flight suit, a new flight suit, if theater gives it to you with the whole parachute and everything, that you wouldn't be able to fit into your car. So you do have a car now?
I have a car now.
And you're driving that car. I mean, not this exact moment you're sitting in the studio, but...
No, I've seen him drive. Okay. He pulled away and his trunk was open the other day. Do you remember this?
Yeah, I remember that. I saw the light on my trunk and I just got up, put the trunk down and...
Was there a body in the back?
No, he's driving in front of me and his trunk is completely open. And I'm trying to signal him that you can't go too far with the trunk. Not just a little bit open, completely open. So eventually, before he gets on the freeway, thank God he pulled over and he got out and he closed it shut. That could have been dangerous, man.
I know. I saw the light. The indicator light on my dash. Oh, my trunk's open. Get out and close it.
It's bouncing up it.
So, well, let's find out more about you. So you're 39 years old. Mm-hmm. You have two children, you said. Yep. Yeah, these are... what do you have, boy and a girl?
One boy, one girl.
And how old are they?
My daughter's 8 and my son is 7.
Okay, perfect. And like you said, he's been married for 10 years. Tell me some things that you are interested in.
One of them is this.
He brought in a book. It's
the WWE Encyclopedia.
Okay.
And I got into that when I was about 15, but one of the other things of my interest is music. You know, any subject that just piques my interest, if it's an interesting article. So it's a lot of stuff. It's too many to list.
Mm-hmm. You mean like politics?
Pardon me?
Politics you like? Or?
Politics, I don't know about politics, but if it's a big story.
Riz, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Hi, Riz.
Hey, good morning.
Hey, what's up?
Morning.
Okay, so I just pulled over. I had a flat tire, so I missed the introduction to your new intern. And I have to tell you, after I fix my tire and I get in, I want to ask him if his dad is Kermit the Frog or Pee Wee Herman, because this dude's got me in stitches just by his voice.
Well, I appreciate that, but no, my dad is I'll say this respectfully. My dad is a retired car salesman. And
Was the name Kermit or Pee Wee?
No.
All right, thank you, Riz.
Right now, I'm going to just let you know, my dad's right now listening to this show.
Oh, but perfect.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Dad.
Yeah, hi.
This is almost like a dream come true for him, I'm sure. I mean, to hear his son on the radio finally, yeah. Right?
It's just the beginning right here.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Just the start. You know that.
Yep.
I predict an illustrious career.
I told my dad, this show is a little off the wall, so he knows what to listen for. You know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sure.
So your interests, you said WWE. You brought in a WWE encyclopedia.
It's just a comprehensive listing of all the guys, some of the big events, and the title histories.
Uh-huh. That's the most interesting?
I thought it's one of the most interesting things, and I've also been a big airplane buff.
What's the biggest match of all time? Do you remember the date and what happened?
I remember the biggest match I can recall was when Andre the Giant was beaten by Hulk Hogan at WrestleMania 3 in March of 1987 when he packed the Pontiac Silverdome over 93,000 people. That record has not been broken.
93,000.
I'm not kidding. 93,173 was the exact count.
So the Nature Boy Hulk Hogan got beat by Macho Man Andre the Giant.
No. It's Hulk Hogan defeated Andre the Giant for the to retain his world heavyweight title at the time, because he was the WWE champion at the time.
And that's the biggest.
One of the biggest matches I can recall.
Remember that Andre the Giant picked up Hulk Hogan, Rover, and he slammed him down.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yep, he did that. And Hogan in a bear hug. I thought Hogan was going to tap out, but he didn't.
Hogan,
I mean, how you gonna get out of a bear hug on a guy from a guy giving to you from a guy that's 7'5", weighing over 500 pounds? It can't be done.
But he did it.
He did it though.
It's the first time ever Andre the Giant body slammed Hulk Hogan.
Yep, and then Hogan turned around and body slammed him and dropped the atomic leg on him. To beat him.
The atomic
leg.
But
what I'm saying, what I'm getting at, what I'm getting at, Dieter, is that is it's the size of the venue. You think
that's the point.
That's like the whole thing. I mean, like the greatest camera pan I ever saw was like when they do the intro music and that thing opens up and the camera slowly swings out to where you're seeing the ring.
Yeah.
And I was like, that is awesome. That's like the most awesome sight in the world. The closest to that record being broken is when they had WrestleMania 23 in Ford Field in Detroit, but they couldn't use the whole stadium because the staging that they use now is it takes up some of that seating space.
Who was the main event in 23?
Was The Rock versus Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, what was the attendance there?
It was 80,800, and it took The Rock three rock bottoms to put Stone Cold Steve Austin down.
Three rock bottoms?
Yeah.
Explain what a rock bottom is to a non-wrestling fan.
Well, he throws you in a ropes, and he just grabs you and just takes you up and just throws you back first into the ring, into the mat. And then he follows up with the people's elbow. And the way he does that, he just rips off his elbow pad, goes like this with his arms, and just comes off the ropes and just... drops it right on your sternum.
You gotta see the Rock impersonation. Can you do the Rock impersonation? This is dead on.
If you smell what the Rock is cooking.
That was, you know, it was almost, Jeffrey, I almost thought I was in there with Dwayne Johnson, the Rock. I mean, that was...
How about the Macho Man? Rover actually met the Macho Man, Randy Savage, before.
I met him at the Autorama one year. He was really nice.
Oh, Rover hates him. he would want to kick Rover's ass.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Can you do it? Can you do his voice?
Oh, it's it. Give me a minute.
Woo, yeah! Dig it!
Yes. That's, wow, that was bringing back chills, almost like my fight with Macho Man Savage.
He jumped back.
Who else do you have in your repertoire?
We were just naming off wrestlers the other day, and he was just doing, boom, just change character like that. He's very talented. Lex Luger.
No, I'm the total package.
Hulk Hogan.
Will you tell you something, brother?
Ric Flair.
Woo!
Roddy Piper.
Wait a minute. I'm Roddy Piper, and you ain't seen nothing yet.
Jake the Snake Roberts.
Wait a minute. Give me a minute. I gotta remember Jake Roberts' voice. If you start playing with snakes, you're gonna get bit. Jake the Snake Roberts, I like because of his cryptic interview style.
You should explain that to me. What do you mean by that?
What I mean is he just had a way. He made his interview sound creepy because that was his wrestling character, you know, and And another wrestler I liked was Stone Cold Steve Austin. Goes, and that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Now, so you obviously are a huge wrestling fan. You sit and you watch wrestling every time it's on television, I'm
assuming?
When
I get the chance. Mm-hmm. And when my kids aren't hogging the TV.
Mm-hmm. So you sit and religiously watch all of the matches.
I used to religiously watch it on the weekends when I was younger. But now with my working... and interning and going to school, I just don't have the time. I try to catch up with it on YouTube, you know, on the internet. Right. So I try to, and I also like to watch a lot of the old wrestling footage.
We were talking about YouTube. What's that?
That's the website you can watch any video you can think of.
Get out. Get out.
Because
wait a second. So I can just put something in there and watch it.
Yeah, basically.
What's that site?
YouTube. Broadcast yourself is its motto.
Oh, okay.
Let me look it up.
How do you spell? Is it just a U or is it
Y-O-U? Y-O-U-T-U-B-E.
Okay. .net?
No, .com.
Okay. You're in broadcasting school. You've been doing that for how long now?
About 4 months.
4 months.
I started in November.
And you've really been learning a lot there.
I learned, and I got to meet, I met Jen Hartcher from 19X. You knew she came in, was a guest speaker. I met...
Now, what do you anticipate your broadcast career? I mean, here you are, an intern on Rover's Morning Glory, the biggest radio show around. What do you see yourself in the broadcast field? What do you see yourself doing?
I want to see myself learning as much as I can, but I like to see myself doing talk radio. Talk or music radio. Everyone says
it's almost
voice.
Pretty much all of radio. I mean, talk radio or music
pretty
radio.
Pretty much radio, you know.
I mean, we have silent radio would be the only other.
No, because if the show went silent right now, you know how fast your broadcast, your program director would be in here? You'd be in here in 2 seconds flat.
No, that's right.
Or maybe quicker.
Now, what is it speaking of 2 seconds flat, I hear that you go to the restroom here and you time how long it takes. Is that true?
No. I just do it at the commercial breaks because I unfortunately I have high blood pressure. I take a medication that makes me go to the bathroom more than I want to.
It's a water pill
basically.
You urinate more.
And I just don't like to have to do it, but I have to. It's something you got to do.
How often does it make you go?
If I time a record, if I take the pill, I only have to go maybe in a half an hour, maybe like twice.
It's two times in half an hour. So you're going every 15 minutes.
The type of medication I take is basically a water pill.
Because you have high blood pressure?
Yeah, I have high blood pressure. It runs in my family.
Mm-hmm.
When your wife, I remember you told me, what did your wife like about you when she first met you? What part?
Wait till I tell you this one. I'll try to keep this one clean. We read her, we're Roman Catholic, so we go to what's called a pre-canon workshop. okay? And the minister said for the women to get up and tell, for each one of them to tell them what's the thing that attracted you to your, you know, your mate, your prospective husband. She stood up and said, the thing that attracted me to my husband is his backside.
Your ass. He's known for his ass, she said.
Oh, really?
I did check it out. It is nice.
Oh, wow.
Sorry.
And so what do you, so you see yourself getting into music or talk radio.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, like a talk show or something?
Talk show.
What would you talk about on your talk show?
I'd do more like Open Lines America.
Open Lines. So you, just anyone?
Any, I mean, let the callers call in, you know, if it's something you want to talk about, you know.
It's like Love Line.
Would you like to take some phone calls?
I'll take a couple
Dumb, why don't you, anyone who is...
Like Loveline, Rover, like sex advice?
Sure, absolutely.
Oh, let me
just...
Any subject.
Any question, anything.
Any kind of question.
Any question.
Okay.
Any question, whether it be current events, whether it be wrestling, whether it be aeronautical.
For Jeffrey, not questions for Jeffrey, but questions that Jeffrey could answer, correct? Or anything.
That's right, anything.
Anything I can answer, anything I have good knowledge about.
Everyone, let me just go to line six. You can clear the rest of the lines, Dumb. They're all filled up with people wanting to talk to him. But let me start from scratch.
I think I was that popular.
You are, man.
1-866-YO-ROVER. That's 1-866-967-6837. So you'll talk about anything. So that's your goal, is to get a talk. Well, you're certainly in the right place. I mean, you've heard of Clear Channel Broadcasting, right?
Yes, I have. I've heard other radio hosts mention it.
Mm-hmm.
And, I'll just leave it at that.
And what do you mean by that? You've heard other radio hosts mention it?
What I'm saying is I've heard the in the afternoon I listened to one of the other stations.
AM station?
Yeah,
FM station? AM. Trevisano?
Yeah.
Jabba the Hutt is what I call him. You ever seen him in person?
I've seen a picture of him.
Oh, yeah.
It's not
you
want to
punch him?
Yeah.
You want to punch him out?
Let's just say he's an interesting person to listen to.
Uh-huh.
It means he wants to knock him out.
So you know that he works for Clear Channel as well. And so what do you know about Clear Channel?
They have six stations in this building, and they're all on this floor.
Right.
And didn't you see Rover's billboard? Did you almost crash? You were looking at it? Is that how you first heard of... You're like, I want to be an intern now because you saw the billboard.
Well, here's how it all came about. When I was in my class, someone came in and said that, you know, you're looking for an intern, and they wrote Doogie's email address on the, you know, dry erase board. So I just jotted it down, fired off an email to her, and told her I was interested, pasted my resume, and boom.
But then you saw the billboard. You said, you're like, oh, this is a sign of God or something.
Well, I would say the sign. It was like. He sounds interesting, so I just start, and then when I tune into his show, when the first chance I got, and I was like, oh, I got to intern with this guy.
Uh-huh. Perfect.
Perfect. That is absolutely perfect. Let me go to April, who has personally knows Jeffrey, and then we'll just start. I'm going to blow through. I'm going to spend about 5 minutes just blowing through as many calls as possible.
Five?
Well, I'm running behind here, douche. April, go ahead. You're on Rover's Morning Glory. Hi.
Hello. I just have a quick question for Jeff. Does he still carry his book bag everywhere he goes?
Oh, thank you. Appreciate that.
Did you carry a book bag around a lot?
No, I only carry it when I'm walking to and from when I'm walking from my car to my school. That's the only time.
But you have it here because I tripped on it.
Yeah, I have it here.
Did you, April?
It's got all my school stuff.
How do you know that, April?
We went to Marshall together. He was in love with my sister.
Oh, he was? You were in love? Were you in love with her sister?
Michelle.
Do you
He's
remember?
Blushing.
Did you like her?
Do you remember Michelle, Jeffrey?
Well, I just thought she was just a nice person. I was nice. I mean, all the girls I knew in Marshall were all nice.
Did you ever kiss him?
He was very nice, but... He was really nice to my sister.
Extra nice, huh? Sure.
And we couldn't get over the book bag thing. No matter where, when, wherever, he always had his book bag.
Well, he likes to be prepared.
That's good.
Yes.
How'd you know you liked her? Did you lactate or did she lactate?
No, just by conversation.
Okay. No body part of yours lactated? Dwayne in Columbus, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Hi.
Hey, how y'all doing? Love the show. Love the new intern you got there.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate that.
Yes, sir. Hey, man, I got a problem. You just seem very knowledgeable.
My wife, we've been married for 20 years.
Well, that's a long time.
She's been accusing me and thinking I'm cheating on her and stuff because I haven't been wanting to make love to her. And the problem is I don't want to be with her anymore because I've been having relations with my dog, and I wanted to know if she could help me out with that.
Well, I don't know if I can really help you out in that regard, but that sounds kind of gross.
Well, what do you say, though?
Have you tried it, man? It's awesome.
No, I don't go that route, pal. I don't go that route.
So what would you say to him?
I would say my advice to you is, I really don't have advice for something like that.
If it makes him happy to be with the dog, should he be with the dog?
Wait a second. If you're going to have a talk show, you've got to be able to move from topic to topic to topic and just roll with it.
Okay. Here's the thing. If you like your dog, well, then, as Steve Winwood used to say, just roll with it.
All right, let me go to
who?
Steve Wood Win?
When I told him if he likes his dog, fine. As Steve Winwood would say it, roll with it, baby.
Do you know who Steve Winwood is?
Oh, Steve Winwood, the song.
Singer?
Yes.
Oh, not the song.
I thought you said Steve Irwin,
no,
the
no,
crocodile
Steve
hunter.
Winwood. No,
the
I said Steve Winwood, the
writer.
Singer.
Who?
Yeah.
You remember the.
Wait, what's his name?
Steve Winwood.
Jeffrey, can you sing this?
He's got to drink some more water.
I don't know the words to this song that well, but just roll with it, baby.
Well, let's get to the chorus. Here, it's coming up.
With it, baby.
Oh, yeah. Keep going.
See, I only heard the song.
Here we go. Here's coming.
Roll with it, baby. Da, 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 da. Roll with it, baby. Roll with it, baby.
Yeah. One more time.
With it, baby. Woo!
All right. Jeffrey, I heard that you could rap a Snoop Dogg song. Is it true?
Well,
nothing but a G thing?
It was the only rap song I probably knew almost all the words to, but it goes like this. It goes 1, 2. 3 and 2 to 4. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Jeff is at the dough, ready to make an entrance. So back on up, pop a little strap off and cut. Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble. Compton and Long Beach together. Now you know you in trouble because ain't nothing but a G thing, baby. Too low down, G's gone crazy. Death Row is a label that pays me. Unfazable, so please don't try to phase me. But back to the lecture at hand. Perfection is perfected, so I'm a lamb. Understand from a young G's perspective. And before me, I have to find a contraceptive. You never know, she could be earning a man and learning a man. Then at the same time, I'm burning it, man. Now what you burning all my chill for? Because ain't no loving good enough to give her while I'm up in it. And that's relevant and real deal, homie feels. And now you hookers and hoes know how I feel. But if it's bringing me up a proper chunk, I take a small piece of something that funky stuff. It's like this and like that and like this, Santa. It's like this and like that and like that, Anna.
Yeah.
Awesome. He got every single word. Wow. Every word.
Dan, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Good morning, Dan.
Morning.
Hey, Rover, how you doing?
Good.
Good. I heard Jeffrey talking before. He was very knowledgeable about flight suits and about airplanes and then jets and everything. So I wanted to get his opinion on something. One of the most famous movies of all time, Top Gun.
You're taking me back to when I was 16.
Jeffrey, but you were 16, but if you remember, the goose dies when the canopy blows off the jet and he hits it and he breaks his neck. But in reality, that can't happen because when a jet is moving, you're actually moving with the jet. You're going to be long gone by the time that the canopy, it wouldn't still be above you. You'd be way past it. So I wanted to get your opinion on that. What were your thoughts on that?
I think they probably added that on because I heard the commentary for that movie, and there's some kind of phenomenon with that because the jet was kind of like in a flat spin. The plane, both engines flamed out.
Went ballistic, right?
Well, the plane went into a flat spin, and for some reason, the canopy was just kind of hanging above it. Because the jet had no momentum.
It's possible, you think.
It's possible. It's a possibility. If both engines flame out one at a time and the plane goes into a flat spin, you're struggling to reach the eject. The F-14 has the ejection handles on the headrest.
Have you been in one before? Is that how you know all this?
I've seen the movie, and I got up close to an F-14 at the air show.
Wow. Frank, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Good morning, Frank.
Morning.
Hey.
Morning.
Good morning, Jeff. I have a question for you.
Go ahead.
Ever buy your underwear at Kmart in Cincinnati?
What?
We may have to make a special trip there. Can't get the underwear anywhere else.
No,
I'm taking him to Vegas.
Oh God, my wife loves to go to Vegas.
Uh huh. Do you? Are you good at blackjack? Are you? Do you know how to count cards?
My wife and I like to do the slots.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, the penny slots, right?
Yeah, pretty much. You know, because you know, I'm not the biggest gambler. I mean, I like gamble a little bit, but I'm not the biggest one.
Sam, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. Hi, Sam.
Rover, how you doing?
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, I got a quick question for your super expert here.
I would call myself super expert.
Whatever. You said a minute ago that at WrestleMania 19, it was Stone Cold. I mean, at WrestleMania 23, that it was Stone Cold against The Rock. That didn't happen at no WrestleMania 23. What the hell are you smoking? That happened at WrestleMania 19. The main event at 23 was Shawn Michaels against Cena. Dude, you can't even get your story straight.
Wow.
You're full of it. You suck. And
well, you know what, pal? I just got a little caught up in the excitement of being able to talk on the radio. But I'm sorry about the mistake, though. So I'm just gonna roll with it.
If he's gonna be that excited and you can't even talk right, then there ain't no way in hell you can compete to Rover, man.
Well,
I'm not trying to compete with Rover. I'm not trying to compete with Rover at all. I'm trying to learn as much as I can about him.
How to do the show, okay?
You gotta understand. Don't go that route, okay? I made a mistake. I'll admit that.
You're on going to school. Say your prayers. Eat your vitamins. Go ahead. Watch Hulk Hogan again, and just relax and learn. You know, because
that's what I tend to do.
All right, thank you, Champ. You're not well.
I think
I think we have to cut Jeffrey some slack.
You're doing great.
I mean, this is the first time on the radio. I mean, what do you think of those comments?
I'll admit, I got that one. You know, kind of mixed up I'm excited that the chance to talk on the radio, talk with you guys, and talk about wrestling. You know, and I don't say about that guy.
But he called you a jerk, man. What'd you think?
I don't know. Just that,
tough skin, kiddo.
Do you think a good practice thing would maybe he does the aftermath today by himself? he hosts the whole thing, full hour long. Gives him a good forum.
As a matter of fact,
I think maybe we schedule that in the future. Let's get him get it settled in here.
I got my WWE encyclopedia with me, and I got the list of WrestleManias, you know, where they took place and the matches. Sure.
Did you bring that in your book bag?
Yep, I got my book bag. It's got all my school materials in it that I need.
Ryan, you're on Rover's Morning Glory. I do have to take a break in a moment. Go ahead, Ryan.
Hey, I had a question for Jeff. I wanted to get into your marriage life a little bit.
Said it again?
I wanted to get into your married life a little bit. I have a one-year anniversary coming up this Saturday.
Uh-huh.
And I wanted to ask you what you think I should do with my wife for our 1 year.
Well, your first anniversary is a big milestone. Take her to a nice, do something simple, you know, like a nice dinner, a nice movie, you know. That's what I do with my wife. When we had our first anniversary, that's what we did. We went out to dinner. Dinner and a movie.
Well, I meant like sexually. Should I down on her?
You two need to get the honeymoon suite.
Anal.
Get the honeymoon suite.
Get the honeymoon suite, huh? I mean, do you have a pretty active sex life with your wife? I mean, she satisfies you in every single way.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You've no complaints there in the bedroom? I mean,
no complaint.
Dumb's been married. I don't know if he told you this or if you've heard any of this. I mean, Dumb's been married a few years now, and his wife won't put out to him.
Well, That's something that Dumb and his wife have to kind of work out.
Any advice, though, for me, though? We're having some issues. You have kids, too. It's been, you know, since we had our son about a year ago.
Uh-huh.
It's been like that. Any advice?
You have to be patient. You know, you both have to be in the mood.
I'm always in the mood. She's not. That's my point.
Well,
what do I do to get her in the mood?
Well, the first thing you have to do is make sure your son is sleeping. Okay.
Oh, no, he sleeps in the room right next to us.
That's not good.
Oh, okay.
You guys have to have your privacy.
Okay. Check. Next.
And then the next thing is you have to... It's a little iffy.
Just take it out or...
Well, put on some romantic music. Maybe that might get her in a mood. I don't know Barry White.
Whitney Houston?
I say like Barry White or Teddy Pendergrass. That's baby making music.
Oh, yeah.
Teddy Pendergrass. Okay.
So you have your wife satisfies you in every. How often is she putting out to you?
it's kind of unpredictable because, like I said, we have the kids and I'm working, so it's like whenever she's in the mood, I get in the mood.
Sure, right, right.
I let her sort of set the tone in a way because...
I mean, just ballpark it. I mean, how often are you thinking?
At least 3-4 times a month.
3-4 times a month. So probably once a week, roughly.
Roughly.
Yeah, hey, that's not bad. I mean, after 10 years of marriage.
Not bad.
Yeah, what do you expect?
Has it kind of gone down since the beginning? I mean, were you guys going at it like all the time in the beginning?
In the beginning, we were going at it because we were attempting to have a child.
Sure, right.
You
know. Right? You should tell her you're going to keep attempting to have another child.
Well, let's just say... She, unfortunately, when my son was born, she had some complications, and her doctor advised her not to have any more kids.
Oh God, dude. That's horrible.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, so.
That's terrible. Very sad.
But like I said, I got two beautiful kids. They're very active, and they got more energy than I do. I'll tell you, keeping up with them is a challenge.
I can't believe that they have more energy than you.
Oh, kids always have energy.
Jeffrey is our new intern.
Good job, Jeffrey.
Good job.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. I think you'll have a lot to learn here.
Just take it one day at a time.
Yep.
Let me go to line one before I take a break. Go ahead, Ryan.
Hi. Yeah, I was just calling Jeffrey. What are your opinions on Bigfoot? I know Dieter's big into that. I'm wondering what your thoughts were on it.
Well... That's always. I've seen documentaries about Bigfoot, and if he really exists, he's very reclusive. You know, I mean, he doesn't want to come out. I guess he seems like he's. I mean, they say he's out there, and he's out in the woods, out up somewhere in Washington. Hey, I got a good one for you. Remember the DB Cooper?
The plane, the guy who
parachuted from a 727 to the rear,
right.
Out of a 727. When that happened, they took the 727s had to be retrofitted, so they could not open that back door in flight.
Mm-hmm.
That was, you know, because
I didn't know that. You know that, Robert?
What does it have to do with Bigfoot?
Well, nothing, Bigfoot, really. If he exists, he exists. You know, I mean, everyone has their own opinions. That's what makes this country go around.
Sure, right.
You know, that's what I always believe. Everyone has an opinion about something. You may not agree. You may like or dislike it, but you just have to, I just like to listen to different opinions, even if I do or don't agree with it.
So is there a tie with DB Cooper and Bigfoot? Is there a lead there, or no?
He just happened to parachute into the same part of the country up in the upper northwest. Where Bigfoot is said to exist.
Is it possible? They've never found D.B. Cooper. They don't know if he survived. This is a guy who did a midair hijacking and parachuted out with a bunch of money. They never found. They found some of the money buried in a riverbank, but they never found his body. They don't know what happened. Is it possible?
He could still be alive. If they've ever found his body, because my dad and I had this, we had a discussion about the Anglin brothers, the guys that escaped from Alcatraz back in the 60s, and my dad thinks they're still alive because their bodies were never found.
Do you think it's possible that D.B. Cooper, you said it was in the same part of the country where Bigfoot, do you think it's possible D.B. Cooper parachuted and Bigfoot got him on the ground?
It's a possibility. Who knows? Anything, there's a saying goes, anything's possible.
That's right. Well, believe me, you, anything is possible. That's right.
He's here.
That's right. Jeffrey, well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome.
You seem to be a very outgoing guy, very friendly guy,
yeah,
very outgoing. And maybe someday we'll get to meet this wife of yours and kids. Sometime, you know, off the air. I'm not talking about on the show, but you know, seems like a very nice guy, Jeffrey. And we wish you the best of luck here on the show. And you know, you stick with the. You know, with Doogie in particular, and she will really teach you all sorts of stuff. So,
all right,
Jeffrey, our new intern, Jeffrey.
Welcome.
All right, let me take a quick break. We will be right back on Rover's Morning Glory. Hang on,
Rover's Morning Glory. Really, American Idol's still on TV? It's that kind of thing that pisses us off, and we're.